Diaget agus Cade Falcha, is Misha Daithi MacMahon. Hello, I'm Daithi MacMahon, and welcome to Our Story, a history of the Irish in Derby. I'm originally from Inchicore in Dublin, but after stints in Canada, Paris, and County Kerry, I've been a resident here in Derby these past 4.5 years. Our Story is an oral history project that I'm proud to be part of, with the support of the Irish community here in Derby, the Irish Department of Foreign Affairs, and the University of Derby. The project aims to collect the personal experiences of the Irish diaspora and act as a celebration of the links between Ireland and Britain. We're keen to understand what impression this film has had upon you, so it would be grateful if you could take 2 to 3 minutes to complete the short survey on the website below. And if you would like to share your story with us, we'd be delighted to hear from you, so please do get in touch. So now, without further ado, let's get to the film. And first, Martin Cassidy will offer a bit of background to the project. Slán, agus beannacht.
I'm Martin Cassidy. I'm one of the members of the Derby St. Patrick's Celebration Committee. The project is called Our Story, A History of the Irish in Derby. Our main aim is to capture the individual stories of the Irish community in terms of them moving to England and settling and making a life for themselves in Derby. We really want to find out about people's individual stories. To hear about, you know, why they came to England, to hear about them settling and making a life for themselves and their family in Derby. And really it's about them telling their personal story. The project overall is called Our Story because we feel that's made up of the individual stories of the community in Derby. And we really, really would like people to come forward to participate in this project. If you're interested in participating in the project, then contact myself, Martin Cassidy, or Mary Murphy, or any of the other members of the Derby St. Patrick's Celebration Committee.
My name is Patrick Francis Dwyer, and I come from a little village called the Swan in County Leash. I live in Little Over now, and I first came to the UK in 1954. When I was 14 years old, and I worked in London. So I came to England to a place called Shepherd's Bush in London, where I stayed with my uncle for a while. And then I got a job in the post office, selling postage stamps and sending out telegrams. But I didn't like it. I only stayed there about 5 weeks. And then I got a job making sausages, Wall Sausage Factory. And I gradually went from one job to another and stayed a long number of years with them lads. And then I moved up to Manchester in about 1960. And I got a job in the mine, working down the coal mines. In the mine, there had to be a certain fella appointed for to handle the explosives. And I never thought for 1 minute that a fellow with an accent like mine and come from Ireland would be put in charge of explosives. But that was my job. For every time we drilled the holes in the tunnel, I would do the blasting. When I came over here and I went to work in the coal mines, some of the lads got wind of it that I used to do a bit of boxing. So there was a fellow there, he used to be a trainer, and he asked me to join their club. And I joined it, and I think it was about 1963, I won the light heavyweight champion of the NCB, that was the National Coal Board. And the trainer said to me, after the bout, and I got the medal, he said, look, he said, Patrick, he used to call me, he said, you'll always be a fighter, but you'll never be a boxer. So I knew it was time to hang him up. He was right.
My name is Ellen McGraw. I was born in a place called Clonbrick, which is in the parish of Solihull in County Tipperary. But I first of all went to school in a place called Isle Capa White. It was the national school. And our headmaster there was Mr. O'Donovan. a very fine teacher, but he had a great love for Irish history, but a bit slanted. So I grew up with a very Republican outlook, and I got rid of that when I came to England. I loved my primary school with Mr. and Mrs. Dunham. There was only two of them, but it was only about 500 yards from where we lived, and we could come home for our lunch, which was a big treat. Not only would we come home, but my mother would have six or eight other youngsters who'd forgotten their lunch, because my mother's bread was better than their mother's, and she'd come in and do them bread and butter and jam, and they'd love it. There was only 70 nuns in Derby when I entered. They didn't really give me much choice about what I wanted to be, but what I didn't want to be was a nurse. I didn't want to be a nurse, so they said, then in that case you can be a teacher. So I went to Digby Stewart Training College in London and spent 2 years there, and came back, and I was only back probably 6 months when the superior said to me, I want you to sign this paper. So I said to her, I had great courage, I said to her, well, my mother said I mustn't sign anything unless I know what it is. Well, she said, it's where you're going to teach. And I said, where is that? She said, Swaddling Court. Well, I'd never heard of Swaddling Court. And it was 18 miles outside Derby, a little place in mining area. And so I signed up.
My name is John Devaney. I come from Pontoon Road in Castlebar, outside Castlebar. And I left there when I was 18 to come to England, to Leeds. Well, good life, yeah. No one had any money, but it was a great life somehow. You didn't need much, did you? Because no one had much. Your neighbours didn't have big cars or anything like that, did they? They had nothing. A train journey, it cost £3.17 and sixpence to get from Castlebar to Leeds. That was the boat, train, back down, that was it, yeah. Leaving me parents and that at home and my brothers and sister wasn't too nice, but leaving, when you saw the lights dimming and then there was none, that was probably the saddest part. So you were going into the unknown then, weren't you really? My wife, Sue and Ken and Christine and Paul. And we go out every Saturday night somewhere. Could be Matlock, Belper, Duffield, Derby, Wellington, anywhere. Someone will say, well, that's where we go Saturday night, and we go. And that friendship has lasted 18 years and we still go out. So, very nice, very nice.
The name is Paddy Conlon from Killeenduff, Eastkey, County Sligo. I first come to England in 1965. It was quite sad, actually. My sister, Kathleen, was a nurse in London, in Edgware General, and she came home to get married on St. Patrick's Day, 65. She was going with her intended to pick the cake up the day before, and he got killed in a car crash, along with a cousin of mine. My sister wasn't badly injured at all, thank goodness. My brother, younger brother and sister, did get badly injured. But my sister decided to come straight back to London to carry on with her nursing about 3 weeks after the accident. And I came with her to give her moral support, if you like. I suppose, yeah, I was toying with the idea of coming over anyway, because I was working about 75, 80 hours a week in the general store for a fiver a week, which wasn't great money. Then in 1969, come to Derby. Got a job on the buses as a conductor. I mean, where I come from is a lovely spot, like I say, right beside the sea. So Derby is quite away from the sea. So yeah, I miss that, yeah. I remember going to the King's Hall to a meeting along with about 800 others, hoping to convince Brian Clough not to go to Brighton, to come back and stay with Derby County. But it was too late. He'd already signed for Brighton.
My name is Monica Dwyer and I'm from County Roscommon. And I now live in Derby after travelling many, many places, such as Australia. We lived for 7 years. We started off in Manchester where I met Paddy. And we went from there to Australia and back to Ireland, then back to Derby, and back to Ireland again, then lived in Buxton, had a guest house there, and back down to Derby, and that's where we are at the moment. We had, in Ireland, we had a little farm and a shop, a grocery shop. So I had a stepfather and he used to go out in the van to all the houses and deliver the groceries and all that. But things weren't working out too good, so we decided, well, my mum decided we should be moving to Manchester, which we did. This journey over, I don't remember a lot of it. I do remember being on the boat and it was absolutely freezing cold. It was very rough and I remember people being sick, including myself. And I remember getting off the boat and coming on the train to, from Holyhead, I would imagine, to be Manchester. And it was like 3 o'clock in the morning and I thought, I was just bewildered. I was, you know, didn't know what to expect. I was only 14 and a half, not even 15. Well, my husband was in the building trade and it wasn't going too well at the time in the 80s. So he decided to come to Derby. He had a sister, older sister. And she was saying, you know, you should come over to Derby. Probably work is good here. And we're here since. And that's about 17 or 18 years ago.
My name is Peter O'Sullivan and I'm originally from West Cork, a place called Killamatra. It's in the Gaeltacht. And it's halfway between Killarney and Cork, almost halfway. And at the moment now I've been in Derby now for quite a while, and I live in over and a little over. I suppose your childhood, you do idealise it to a degree, and it was out in the fresh air. We did have a poultry farm. That kind of made us stand out a little bit from the neighbours because we smelt different. You know, every time the chicken muck used to get spread in the field, everyone knew about it. But it was an enjoyable childhood. But it was a farming childhood, so we didn't really ever have holidays. It was always working. My parents only had a very small farm. I think it was 26 or 28 acres. And the land was so bad, and this is the truth, the cows used to sink in the field, some of the fields, and we'd have to dig a trench around them and try and rescue the cattle before they ruined their legs. Well, moved over to the UK, it was October the 5th in 1991, and we landed in Hull, and that was to do my last year of schooling. And then moved to Derby then on July the 17th, 1992, and started work on July the 20th, 1992. So I've been here since then. And so the settling in was, it was a process, but it was fine. And I think what actually helped when we moved up, when I bought my first property in Wealden Avenue, there was a network there. There was some really good neighbours and that kind of embedded in, yeah, you can become part of this place even further.
Stephen Gallagher, Achna Sheelan, that's in County Leitrim and in the province of Connacht. Since January 1960, there'll be 59 years in Derby this January. Yeah. If you start to reminisce, we had a fantastic young life. There was 9 of a family, 3 sisters and 5 brothers, who were out in the wilds in Leitrim, where we had our own small holding, and we had our everything you needed. We had the mountain above us, Slieven Éire. Then we had the river out the back. We used to fish for trout and that. And then we used to fish in the lake for pike and shad and all the different types of fish. We used to do a lot of hunting for rabbits and after foxes and badgers. And we had a great youth life, which some mightn't agree with now, but that's the life we had, that was it then. There were great times, and there was a lot of families and friends around, and everybody helped everybody. Well, my first job when I come to Derby with the Irish community was, I used to get the Pioneer books from Dublin, and I used to go to the hall every month and sell the Pioneer books to all these friends that you would know, and people who were pioneers then. And then we carried on. Father Tim came to St. Mary's in 1961, and he was always disappointed that there was nowhere for the Irish to meet or have of their own. So we started having meetings at our house with the hope of one day we would get our own premises, which we did 33 years ago now.
I'm Sarah Ann Coleman. I come from Knock in County Mayo, Ireland. 1955, I came over here. All my friends had gone, and my two brothers had come over, the oldest, and my sister, God rest her, she was working in the town. So there was just me left with my father. And I didn't leave him on his own, and I said I wanted to go because everybody else was gone all around us, and it was a bit lonely, really. So one of my brothers, they used to come home regular from England, and I got him at home, and he went to visit one of his friends, and when he came back, I had gone, because they didn't want me to go. I could have stayed there and had the farm, but I just wanted to go because my sisters had gone, they were gone as well. And my brother stayed at home then with my father. I did like Derby. It was different then than it is now. But I still like Derby. I must have done. I stayed there. So I was always treated with respect. I don't know about everybody else. And my family has always been respected, and I've made them respect everybody. You know what I mean? You bring them up to respect people, and they respect you, you respect them, and that's it. I could have stayed there and had the farm. They wanted me to, but I didn't want to. I'm glad I didn't because, well, it was lonely, I think, when everybody was going away, and we didn't want to leave. I was lonely leaving my father, but I knew my brother wouldn't leave him on his own, you see. So he got there with him, and he was all right.
Yeah, Declan McGuinness, born in 1961 in Dangan, County Offaly. Small town in Offaly, halfway between Tullamore and Edenderry, and born into a big family, a family of 12 children, living in a small two-bedroom cottage about 3 miles outside the village, a corrugated iron roof, and no water, no toilets indoors. We had to head down the fields when nature called. But we were in that house until I was 9 or 10 years of age, and then we got a new house in the village of Dangan, a council house, 3-bedroom, toilet, near the school, etc. It was a massive, massive change in my life, even so young. Eventually, I just decided to make that phone call to my uncle, who lived in London. And made the decision to, big decision to leave. Heartbreaking, really, saying goodbye to my mother. And it happened several times after that. And it was a horrible experience. It was probably the worst bit about it, is leaving your mother in tears on the doorstep. And yeah, it wasn't the straightforwardest of emigrations, really. The Irish club, the thriving Irish club, when we came visiting, yeah, we went to the Irish club all the time. Also, the church, because we had mass goers and you meet people there. We had my sisters already living here and their families, so through them you get to know people. But the Irish club was really thriving at the time, and with second generation, with Irish as well as immigrants like myself. So it was an easy place to meet people with lots of stuff in common.
Sheila Galvin from Cork, by County Cork, Blarney, County Cork. There was no work in Ireland, so I came over in 1954. I don't know how you'd explain it. It was very different because Blarney was a sort of a country place, and Derby was a town. I associated with the Irish. The English, don't get me wrong, I was very pleased with the English and the way the Irish, the IRA, were carrying on. I was very pleased. The English didn't do me any harm. They were ever so good. They were so ever so nice to me. The people of Derby were very nice people, yes. I was over here a fortnight and I wrote to my sister. My mother was dead at the time. I wrote to my sister and I told her I was here. So she said, "What are you doing in that foreign land? What are you doing in the foreign land?" She said, "You don't know anybody over there." "You don't know anybody over there." So she says, "Come back." And I never came back. I go over as often as I can. But otherwise, well, I mean, I brought my family up here, so this is where I have made me home since.
Eben Murray, originally from Roscommon, Ireland, and now living in Derby. Well, a bit apprehensive, really. I was travelling with a chap I met. He was home from holiday, Jim Merton. But he was on holiday from England. So I met him, and he said to come back with him. Plenty of work in England, yeah. When they bought the Irish Centre in 1985 in Beckett Street, I became a member and was a committee member for a while as well, a couple of years. The first dance I went to was the Ritz Ballroom off Normanton Road. And that's where I met my wife-to-be, actually, in 1956, yeah. I mean, they got crowds up to 42,000 in the baseball ground. There'd be all the different areas of the ground, you know what I mean? There was the Osmonton Inn, the Normanton Inn. There was the pop side, as they called it. And all the younger generation went on that. It was all standing as well, there was no seats. So it was, I think, more exciting than sitting down watching. Yeah. Everyone was close together, you know. Whereas now the struggle to get 28, 29, they're all sitting, you know.
Yes, I'm Mary Judson from North Kilkenny, Ballaragget Parish. This matron was coming over from London to interview staff at the Clubhouse Hotel in Kilkenny. And his friend Joan and I went along and we had an interview. And we were accepted to come to Red Hill in Surrey to do our nurse training. Our managers at the hospital, matrons that were in them days, or assistant matrons or whatever, they were all Irish as well. So we all felt very at home, you know what I mean? And we were looked after and cared for. We had our board and lodgings. Our wages was something like £13 for the month. We came to Derby, you know, and when we came to Derby, people were very friendly. We set up home in Little Over, where I'm still there, 40 years later. And but I do remember arriving in Derby and being there about a year when I was sitting at Derby bus station and waiting on a bus, and there was a gentleman sitting beside me. And it was the funeral day of Lord Mountbatten. And he had the paper, and of course, they were carrying out the coffin. And I had kind of made some kind of a comment to this gentleman, saying, what a tragedy and how awful. And suddenly he said, "Are you Irish?" And I said, "Yes," very timidly. And he said, wondering what was going to come next. And he said, Well, the best player that ever played in the baseball ground was an Irishman. I think I was so shocked to get that reaction that I didn't think of asking him who was the player. England has been good for me and my family, and I'm glad, you know, I came to England when I did. I'd gone to a fortune teller before I came over here who said, you mustn't cross, you're thinking of crossing the water and you mustn't because you will regret it. But I have no regrets.